Batman 89, Batman Returns, Blade, Spider-Man, X-Men, Iron Man, The Avengers, Dread, Batman Begins, Superman Returns, The Dark Knight, Deadpool, Infinity War, Endgame, Kingsman, Kick-Ass, Hellboy, Into the Spider-Verse, The Rocketeer, Man of Steel, BVS, Wonder Woman, Shazam, Zack Snyder's Justice League. What do all of these movies have in common? They all wouldn't exist if it weren't for one movie. Superman 1978. A defining film that shaped the imaginations of a whole generation. A movie that made people laugh, that made people cry, that made people's jaws drop to the floor. A movie that wasn't cynical. It wasn't deconstructing anything. It didn't ask a lot from the audience. It said, hey, just sit back and have a good time. It was a simple but joyful movie that truly inspired hope for millions. With the recent passing of Richard Donner, the director of the film, I felt compelled to talk about this movie a little bit and show it the respect it deserves. And to be completely honest, I don't even really like this movie. I don't. I think the acting is cheesy, I don't really get invested in the script, and the effects look pretty terrible compared to what we can do these days. But you know what? With that being said, I can still admit that this movie is a legendary accomplishment, and maybe the most important superhero movie ever made. Yes, this looks silly now, but we need to remember that before this movie came out, nobody in the genre had effects this good. There were the 1940s Batman and Superman serials, The Adventures of Captain Marvel, The Adventures of Superman, and Batman 66, but none of them were doing the things that this movie did. Most of the shots of Superman flying back then were either from the side view or really close to his face, and it looked so stiff and unnatural. They even used a dummy for most of Captain Marvel's wide shots. But the flying in this movie used different techniques, different camera angles, different speeds. The camera would move like never before, and it was genuinely revolutionary for the time. You felt the true speed and power of a superhero like never before, and it opened the door for future movies to innovate and improve upon. It was the first time people truly felt like a man was flying, and it was mind-blowing. This was the first superhero movie to have these amazing sets as well. Whether it's a crowd of people watching a helicopter fall, Lex's office, or the Daily Planet, this felt like a real, believable world for the first time. People were really handcuffed back in the day because of the resources they had, and it was reflected in the quality of the sets. You got a lot of boring, gray offices and uninspired interior locations. But then look at the Fortress of Solitude. This set is so far beyond anything we had seen before it, and it was unfathomable at the time. No one had ever really seen a superhero live in a world like this before. Then you had stud actors like Marlon Brando and Gene Hackman in the film, which really legitimized the movie for a lot of people who wouldn't have cared otherwise. It showed that top-notch actors could actually be in superhero movies and make it work. It set the precedent for what we see today. Then there is his suit. I think this was the first live-action superhero property to really nail the hero's costume. Every single element is ripped straight from the comics, and it's as close to perfect as you can get. So it showed that you don't have to be ashamed of the source material. Show it in all its glory. And even though he isn't an overly complex character, it's so nice to see a genuinely great guy like Clark Kent. Christopher Reeve was so endearing, and he really brought this element of likability and pureness to the character that is just infectious. He inspires you to be better. You want to be like him. You want to be him. It's actually quite incredible for how cheesy this movie is. And I can't forget to mention the amazing score by John Williams. This score is so great, so iconic, that a lot of people connect it to the core character of Superman now. It has such a hopeful and epic melody, and it just makes you smile. When you hear it, it actually feels like hope is on the way. Like everything is gonna be okay. I know that sounds stupid to say out loud, but honestly, it's one of the greatest scores in superhero movie history, and maybe even one of the best scores in cinema, period. It's that good. So, everything from the actors, the sets, the directing, the editing, the music, the effects, the action, this movie was simply revolutionary. And it is one of the main factors of why superhero movies have been around for so long. Without it, we wouldn't have the MCU, the DCEU, the Dark Knight trilogy, the Spider-Man trilogy, the X-Men movies, or any of it. I'm not exactly sure what superhero movies would look like today if this hadn't come out when it did. It may not hold up to today's scrutiny, but it set so many precedents and did so many things right that I just can't ignore it. It deserves so much credit because of what it did and when it came out. And even though I don't personally love it, it has my utmost respect. Thank you, Superman 78. And thank you, Richard Donner. May you rest in peaceful solitude.